Hello, and I see you, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers. This episode, we're taking a look at the Zardos connector passageway by Zardo. It's not the first one that's done this, but it's a different map. Technically, just a different model, same concept. So, why don't we go over and take a look at this model? And, you know, see how it works. You know, Edison. Now, here is, well, basically it. As you can tell, it's got a slightly different design, which lines up more with the current aesthetics that Space Engineers is going for, as well as this metal plate around the this bit. Not only being the same size as a slab, so you can easily mesh it into an armour, but also can be retextured and recoloured. So, you know, fits in with your ship. I forgot if this bit changes colour too. One way to find out. It is. And yeah. So you see, it's basically a connector that connects on, which also gives you a way to walk through. And you see the connector port on the top and bottom, so you can connect to your conveyor system, so items can be transferred. And these are for, will give you access to them. And they possess an inventory capacity of 72,000 litres, which is more than a small container. Which is interesting. Anyway, well, it's kind of big. So yeah, does that. It's also useful when you want it to, used for parking. You want to activate trading mode. So, you know, that's the store block trade. Yes, back up. Now, as for its build cost, it is. Expensive. At 300 steel plates, 80 construction components, 24 small steel tubes, 16 motors, and 40 computers. So, it needs a lot of steel plates, but other than that, it's kind of a fair price on everything else. And again, it's even a fair price on the steel plates. No, considering how big it is. So that'd be 9 blocks? Yeah, that would be right. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's all there is to it. It's just a large connecting walkthrough. So, how about we pop off into space and take a look at it in action? So here we go. Two ships with the walkthrough connector on the side. So, now we just need to line the ships up. Here we go. Yeah, I can't remember what... Oh yeah, I think I can't remember what thrust I had on this. The modular ones. That's why I didn't have any. Here we go, this is getting a bit closer. A bit more forwards. Crazy thing. And down a bit. You can even use these to create like bridges across areas. You'll see. Wrong button. Then move myself a bit too forwards now. Well, they will connect. This is it. Close enough. Nope, there we go. And connect. Parking engaged. And now let's head downstairs and go through them. And down we go, down we go, all the way to the bottom. I should really update this thing. Quite a few new vanilla blocks have come out. Not only that, they've made their own new version of this sort of ship. Maybe I should go grab that. To use as a test ship for examples. Anyway, let's put the helmet down, because I believe there's going to be no oxygen here. And open up. Yeah, no oxygen. You see, the two sites are connected. Not sure how well you can actually see in here. There we go. You see, they're connected and allow you to walk between the two ships. Thus allowing, you know, easier commute between the two ships, thus for trades and other such things, really. Like resupplying, changing crew. Not only that, you have this on a station, which I think might be one of its intended purposes, obviously. But yeah. Which allows an easy transfer of not only items, but people. So you don't have to worry about flying around. Yeah. So anyway, I'm going to have a link in the description below for this mod. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.